Hi, welcome to Intermission, the introduction to Meraki. I'm Jay, and I'll be your host for this program.
Hey, Mom, who's that?
Rockstar Joe.
I was improvising.
That's right. Hey, everybody. I'm Joseph, a.k.a. Rockstar Joe, and welcome to episode 21 of a Blerd's Intermission podcast. I know usually, you know, we have the little bro as the co-host, but, you know, he's busy boo-loving, you know, shouts out to him, hope he's safe. But today is just, you know, solo dolo, just me. I don't think this is going to be a lengthy episode, but I'ma, you know, still talk to y'all. Today's topics, honestly, there's nothing concrete. There's just a bunch of things I want to talk about that has transpired within the past couple of weeks, honestly. You know, as usual, definitely got the Blerd talk coming up, but you know, just to give you, I guess, a outline for today's show, you know, usual Blerd talk, and then after that talk a little bit about the current state of DC. The current state of DC, you know, the album, the Lakers, you know, how that relates to LA, and then, I don't know, I'll say the last for last and just let that be when it comes up. But, starting with the usual Blerd talk, this week has been, I don't know, I feel like it's been exciting, but also a chill week as far as entertainment goes. With movies, I haven't came across anything new this week. I had the chance to watch the Batman, I forgot the title of it already, but the newest animation from DC regarding Batman. I had looked at that earlier, which was a dope little, I would call it more so of a show instead of an actual movie, because the duration of it was only like 30 minutes. But I'm not sure if DC is going through with this whole, you know, pick, you know, different issues from the comics that they have and then, you know, let it be portrayed via animation. Because if that's the case, I am all in for that. Speaking in general, just the world of, like, comics, you know, Marvel and DC, I just need more entertainment, more things to watch. Because, yeah, I just need new things. Lovecraft Country is about to go off, and I'm kind of moving through with the shows I already have plan for the season, but I can definitely use some out of this world magic, or you know, entertainment, I guess. But moving along with TV shows, you know, as usual, I'm still supporting and loving Lovecraft Country. This past weekend was episode 9, and I mean, it's shit's just getting better. Like, I'm bummed. Because, you know, next Sunday is the season finale. And I don't think they've confirmed whether or not they're coming back for season 2 or not. But that show was too good to just let it be one season, a one and done type shit. But, like I said, Lovecraft Country still taking over my Sundays and Mondays. Beautiful episode, wonderful story. Love the character development. Just in love with the whole scenery. Like, it's, I could talk so much about this shit, man. But, you know, as usual, by all means, when you get some time, go check the show out. Another show that I've been watching as well is What We Do in the Shadows. Originally, this was a movie by I feel like I'm going to say his name wrong, but I'm going to try. Taika Waititi? Basically, the guy behind Thor Ragnarok and the upcoming Thor movie, Thor Love and Thunder, I believe. So, yeah, that's pretty dope. You know, kind of like this docu-series about vampires, but it's more so on the more comical side, but I love it. It's it keeps me entertained. But yeah, that's it for TV shows. For books, I'm supposed to be reading, you know, Black Privilege. Yikes. I'm supposed to be reading Black Privilege by Charlemagne the God. But I've just been so busy, and it's like, once I get to the nighttime, I'm just like, I want to read it, but I'm like, let me just chill. But I'm going to get my shit together. I'm going to definitely start reading. sooner than later. I promise that. As for comics, man, I've been reading a bunch of comics lately. I caught up with the whole Thor series. I read issue number 7 and 8. And yeah, I don't know what to say, man. The story has taken a shocking turn that I wasn't expecting, but at the same time, it's also a relief. But I'm also a little bit worried for Thor and, you know, his future. But you know, we'll have a conversation one day. Hopefully, people get the opportunity to read that. Another comic series that I've been reading as well is called Billionaire Islands, and it's a dope comic. It's a dope comic. I love it. It's about, I think, 6 issues within the whole series. I wish kind of I can explain it, but I can't off the top. But I'll try as I try to think about this. But I would say Billionaire Island is basically, you know, the title sells it to a degree. Like, there is this island where, you know, only billionaires are allowed. And, you know, you get to see through, I guess, a couple different perspectives of just how fucked up the rich can really become and how, you know, little they care. How little they care for the poor. But to a degree, this is more so of a story of, you know, the poor coming back to attack the rich. But with a few surprises. Yeah, definitely check that out when you all get the chance. As for music, this week, I have yet to listen to it. But I need to, because I'm just, you know, committed to, you know, listening to new albums, new songs, just new Fridays, you know, just the opportunity to create, but also be inspired, listen. So I say that to say, this past, you know, New Music Friday, Reason from TDE dropped an album titled New Beginnings. I didn't really read too much into it, but I did get a notification from my phone saying that, you know, Mac Miller fans were outraged with Reason's thoughts, or not thoughts, but, I guess lyrics. I'm not ready for that, especially not putting any disrespect on Mac Miller's name. Like, nah, I get that respect. I get that man respect. And, you know, by all means, I try my best to respect the dead, but I'm not really too interested into seeing what Reason has said in regards to Mac Miller, but I'll be sure to, you know, throw that back in there when I get the chance to listen to the album. Another thing, I know it's been a while since I've mentioned the whole Throwback Sunday selections, but I'm back. This past weekend, I had the chance to go back and listen to a legendary band that your parents' parents probably heard and, you know, grew up on. They're the voices behind some of these classics, such as September, Let's Groove, Boogie Wonderland, Shining Star, and, you know, the list continues, but I'll stop there. If you don't know who I'm talking about by now, it sucks, because I am talking about the legendary group Earth, Wind, and Fire. I didn't really go back and do the whole discography, but I definitely went to the essentials for their collection. Or, yeah, they're the collection. So, yeah, I definitely enjoyed it. Like, definitely there was a part of my Sunday where I was just grooving. I started cleaning shit. You know, the OCD was activated. Just having some good throwback tunes on was just relaxing and just, I don't know, rewarding as well. But, yeah. But yeah, that's it for music. And then, moving on to video games. You know, I added a few more to the collection. Murdered Soul Respect, Street Fighter V, Unravel 2, and Mirror's Edge. The PlayStation Store, you know, currently has some good deals on some games, so took the opportunity to do that. But yeah, look at that, 10 minutes almost. So yeah, that wraps it up with the Blur talk. Along with that, yeah, forgive me if I sound sluggish or my voice is extra bassy. I'm doing this at nighttime, surprisingly, but yeah, anyway, pushing ahead. talking about DC, so I don't know. For me, you know, I definitely try to stay in the loop of what's going on in the DC area. More so DMV, but definitely DC area. You know, regarding, you know, homicides, burglaries, you know, the good and bad. Like, I just try to stay up to date. And I don't know, for a while, you know, I took a little break for a couple of days. And I think it was like Monday or Tuesday where I just had the moment to like kind of gather my thoughts and everything. But in DC, it was a point where it was like within a week, I believe, or in a span of, 3 to 6 days, basically, DC had experienced about 6 or 7 homicides. The age, you know, ranges from the 20s to late 50s, you know. Rest in peace to all those that, you know, have transitioned to a better place. But man, yo, like, I don't know, man, DC, yeah, I don't know what to say this time around. Like, I don't know, shit, I mean, violence is violence, no place is ever perfect, but the fuck are we doing, man? And it's like, you know, like I said, the age, you know, for the victims ranges from 20s to the 50s, but this, the victims, themselves are not just, you know, male. There's been a couple women in that toss up, and it's just like, god damn, yo. Like, man, my city, I think we're on our way to coming back to being the murder capital. Because shit is just getting wild, man. But I ain't going to spend too much time on the sad shit. Like I said, you know, hopefully, as always, for my city, I'll ride for you. I love you. I appreciate you. But nah, we really got to get our shit together, yo. We really need to. All the senseless killings and just, you know, families being hurt. Fucking kids losing their parents. The shit is just tiring, man. It really is. As I'll say, like, the time, like, 2020 ain't been the best year. You know, I'm fortunate to make the good of it, but seriously, man, like, what the fuck can we do? Summer's over, you would think, you know, killings and all that shit would calm down, but it's like, nah, shit's still popping off. Like, even just yesterday, I was thinking about recording, but thank God I didn't, because, my God, yo, just out of nowhere, I think I was working on, some writing, and I was sitting down in my living room, and just out of nowhere, you just hear, like, at least 15 gunshots. Like, shit just rained off. I'm just like, what the fuck, yo? Like, I'm so happy my daughter's not, you know, around here anymore, man, because, I don't know, man, shit like that just scares me. But also just, I don't know, man. But anyway, yeah, moving through. Shouts out to the Los Angeles Lakers. Congratulations to them on winning their 17th championship. I know they're tied with Boston for the most championships by an NBA team. You know, definitely, you know, snooped around on social media. And I definitely seen a lot of people say, you know, this championship was for Kobe. And I definitely agree, but I don't know, man. I feel like I'm the only one that just feels weird about this shit. Because it's just like, you know, Kobe isn't here. You know, the NBA took a break, a pause. It went from, you know, going to arena to just a bubble. And I'm quite sure, you know, with the different outcomes and the circumstances that were given, you know, this is the results we got. By all means, you know, I'm a Laker fan, more so a Kobe fan, but I'm happy we won. I definitely am. Definitely got to, you know, give LeBron his respect, you know, respect where it's due. Like, I get tired of hearing this conversation. Who's the greatest? Who's the GOAT? And it's so disrespectful that people be like, LeBron is. Like, what? Like, what? Do you not? Are we forgetting Kobe? Are we forgetting Michael Jordan? Like, how do we, like, I don't understand it. I don't get it. But I also also realize and understand, like, yeah, it's just another thing of just people having opinions. I mean, but like I said, by all means, LeBron definitely gets my respect. If I had to, you know, share my top five, you know, NBA players of all time in no specific order, I would definitely say, you know, Michael Jordan, Kobe, LeBron. I definitely won't say Iverson because, yeah, I was definitely using Iverson on the NBA Live days. And I probably would say Shaq as well. Like, those are my top five. And it's like, I don't know. I mean, everybody's top five varies, honestly. But I don't know, man. That shit is so subjective, man. So subjective. LeBron is this, LeBron is that. Like, all right, cool. Respect, you know. You can take your, you know, take his meat out your mouth. But but it is what it is. Like I said, man, shouts out to the Lakers. You know, congratulations. Happy we got that tie. I guess let's see if they can do that shit again. Let's see if they can repeat that next year. And then, you know, LeBron will probably be tied with Kobe with five. I'm thinking at that point he'll probably retire, but we'll see. trying to think what else with the NBA. Yeah, I don't know. I don't got much else to say about the NBA. Like, I share my top five. Like I said, definitely happy for, you know, LA, the state of California itself, to finally, you know, just be rewarded some good news. I know LA has definitely been taking fucking major L's. Like, you know, going back from the wildfires, going back to last year to losing Nip, going back to this year, earlier this year, losing Kobe. Like, I can imagine being a, you know, Californian, a person from Cali. I can imagine the amount of depression and just sadness that's all around. I totally can relate. But like I said, man, shouts out to the Lakers. I don't think this was just for Kobe, but I definitely think this was for, you know, both Kobe and Nip. Not even just Kobe and Nip, but, man, Kobe, Nip, Gigi, the victims on that helicopter, just any and everyone who has, you know, rode with the Lakers through the years and greatness of, you know, the duo of Shaq and Kobe, to, you know, just Kobe and, you know, Lamar and Derek, to the Achilles injuries. Like, yeah, man, this is definitely a relief. You know, it's been 10 years since we've won a championship. So, once again, I can't stress it enough or repeat it enough. Congratulations to the Lakers. Moving forward, the album. So I spent pretty much the majority of today just going over the album. Like, I woke up this morning, took a, you know, nice little 3-mile walk, listened to the podcast, Bill Burr's podcast. But yeah, once I came home, I just spent so much time just listening to the album. And there was definitely a few points where I got a little emotional, because I definitely added a lot more to the album. Like, it still kind of cuts underneath an hour still, but I don't know. I think the messaging that I'm trying to get across, what I want to say, all that is there. Like, it's there. I'm just more so anxious to release it, because I've done listen to that shit so many times. Like, I just feel like it's unfair that I listened to it so many times and then I have yet to really share it. But I am happy, because this past weekend I had the opportunity to, you know, let Jakayla hear it. We were just chilling in my room, just listening to the album. And I was so happy, because she was just like, oh my God, like, daddy, this is really good. Like, you should put it on the internet. And I was like, I am. She's like, oh, for real? She just got so excited. Yeah, man, I'm just so excited. I really want to talk more about it, but what's the point? I'm the only person that really knows it all. So we'll definitely have an episode, you know, specifically for the release of the album, the releasing of the album, and just to, you know, talk more about the inspirations, what went into it, and, you know, some of the Easter eggs that's left there. Yeah, what else? Oh, yeah, also, shouts out to the bro McSwain. This past weekend was very eventful, but this past weekend I also had the opportunity to do the little photo shoot for the album. And yeah, like I said, man, that's pretty much what I'm waiting on. Like, the album, I can finally say, like, I'm not touching anymore. I'm not editing anything else. All I need now is just the photos so I can, you know, attach, you know, a photo to the album. And then, you know, talk to the connections, upload it to the streaming services, and then let you all hear it. Because I am tired. Like I said, I'm tired of just holding on to it. But, yeah, man, it's fucking great. I will say this in advance, though. That album, you won't hear any poetry from me. You won't hear any rapping from me because I'm not a rapper. But you can definitely expect just to be a more so like a beat tape, I guess. But this beat tape has a story, you know. But yeah, that's that. Last but not least, I've been telling a few people about this, but I'm definitely ready to tell the world this and conquer it, give an opportunity. So I've been having a few conversations, or I guess a lot of conversations with, you know, friends, young and wise. And I've also been having, like, hints of it, like, just certain, like, I guess, sightings of just pursuing and going further with my career. And so now I've been, you know, reconsidering going back to school to basically pursue my master's degree. And I'm committed to it, man. Like, I've reached out to a couple people to get a couple of letter of recommendations. I've sat down and wrote a couple essays. I done got my transcript. Excuse me. I done got my transcript. I have a college in mind that I want to attend, but I won't share that just yet until, you know, the results are, you know, in and I submit that and I get that. But, yeah, man, I just want to share that with you all. Like, it's never too late, yo. At the age of 25 and with Corona being present, I mean, and with the shit that happened a couple weeks ago with my job, yeah, like, it's never too late to step up and elevate your game again, man. It's never too late. Like, I don't want to spend all my life continuing to say I gotta reinvest myself. Because at some point, you know, you just gotta be like, cool, this is me, this is it. This is what you get, baby. But as far as, like, you know, being a professional, not even just being a professional, being a creative, being a father, a son, and so forth, like, there's just certain things that I owe it to myself and I owe it to my daughter to just do and pursue. Like, I don't want to settle for this shit. Like, I'm happy, you know, I got my bachelor's check, you know, but I ain't trying to settle for shit, man. Like, this whole, you know, living to almost every other paycheck and all that shit, you know, I'm definitely trying my best. Well, now I'm definitely trying my best to save. Like, that's, you know, this is a course and ride that I'm grateful to be on. Because, you know, I tell people, like, you know, it's great to have a destination, but when you can, while you can, enjoy the ride there. Appreciate every single moment that you have making your way towards that direction. Or, I mean, not that direction, but that destination. It's real, though, man. It's just real. Like, I don't know, man. I done lost, I done lost a quite, you know, good few people this year. Health, shit, like, everything just has popped off this year. So, like I said, man, this is definitely something I want to, you know, share with you guys moving forward. I'll definitely keep you all in the loop on the results of how that goes. Goddamn, I don't think there's much else to say. I'm so happy that I committed to doing this shit at nighttime, because my god, yikes, man. But yeah, that's pretty much it, man. Like I said, I don't think this episode would be a lengthy one, but it definitely will be worthy, I guess. I don't know what else to say. You know, next week, episode 22, we'll see when we get there, bruh. Until then, though, you know, all jokes aside, and as I always say, I do hope everyone is okay. You know, I hope you all are safe. I hope you, you know, continue to have a good week. I know on this end, I definitely got some more work to do, but I'm just happy to be on this path again. Until then, you know, stay safe, be safe, you know, teach one, reach one. Love yours, and continue to be the best individual you can possibly be. Yeah. That's that, ladies and gentlemen. Peace, love, and positivity. Peace.
People admit that they're rascals. That's, you see, on the side of the not respectable, the selfish. But so also, all humane people should admit that they're jokers, that they're playing games and playing tricks. That I am doing it on you. I am most ready to admit this. I hoaxed you all into coming here to tell you what? It was a trap, you see? But I'm going to make it an entertaining trap.